In 1983, 80s rock band Journey filmed a music video for their extremely popular song from their Frontiers album, Faithfully. This video gives a visual representation of the harsh life on the road for the rock band. Right before the lyrics begin at the beginning of the song, there's a highway scene that really interested me. And I began researching where this was filmed, and that was easier said than done. In this video, I'll go through the process that led me to this waterway in Miami, Florida, and show you what that same scene looks like 40 years after that video was filmed. The highway in the video will be revealed toward the end of the video, so stick around for that. And with that, let's get started. The Faithfully music video is full of some rare footage that stands out from other music videos that other bands have released. For example, this scene at 2 minutes and 4 seconds in the video was from Provo, Utah on March 30, 1983. At 1 minute and 11 seconds, this came from the concert in Casper, Wyoming on April 1st, 1983, and no, that's not a joke. Oh, girl, just stay by me. These scenes you see on your screen right now come from Orlando, Florida on April 23rd, 1983. I'm forever yours. Under the beach of the world. You're And this scene at 3 minutes and 7 seconds, Miami, Florida on April 24, 1983. There's also one other scene that nobody can forget. It's where Steve Perry shaves his mustache. That is always going to be a classic scene in a music video from 1983. Now, speaking of Florida, this is where the video takes place. This video doesn't just include concert footage from a random assortment of concerts, as only 8 seconds in the video, this scene shows up. When I watched this scene one day, I asked myself, man, I wonder where this comes from. So, that is where this video stemmed from, and when I asked that question, I never would have known how long this would have taken to find this one singular scene. But now I have found it, and I'm going to show it to you. But first, I'm going to give you three other possible candidates that I came up with when trying to research for this video. So, the first highway is located in St. Petersburg, Florida. Now, Journey did not play in the Tampa-St. Petersburg area during the Frontiers tour. However, the band might have traveled through the city on their way to Charlotte, North Carolina from Miami. This is the case because the band would have had to travel north to get to their next city, obviously. But the band most likely took I-95 north on their way to Charlotte, so this probability is the least likely possibility out of all the other ones that I will be talking about in this video. However, looking at this scene compared to a modern-day satellite view, one might say that this was the original scene, and I was like that for a while. However, as I continued to do more research, I started to distance myself from this possibility and became closer to this next possibility just a few miles down the road. Any way you want it, that's the way you need it, any way you want it. This one, I don't have much to say about, as this one is definitely not the one that is in the video, as it looks nothing like the scene in the video, as you can see here. So I believe that this was the scene in the video when I first started doing research, as the band could have traveled through Tampa when traveling from Orlando to Tampa, which didn't seem right to me, as the band did not play in Tampa during the Frontiers tour. Something else that didn't seem right to me was when I drove by this area during my trip to Orlando and Tampa last year, and I saw this area in person. I immediately knew that this wasn't the same highway as in the video when I saw it. Putting this satellite image side by side to the music video, it could have been the same as 40 years ago, but I highly bet that this little peninsula on the right with houses was there in the music video, but I ultimately ended up changing my mind about this possibility, and I ended up finding this next possibility that I believed more than the previous two so far. Looking at this possibility, especially from a map, this one looks kind of like the same area as the music video. However, satellite view tells a completely different story. This one kind of ties in with the last possibility, as it was most likely that the band did not travel through Tampa from either traveling from Orlando to Miami or from Miami to Charlotte. Comparing this to the music video, just like the last possibility, it could have been the same, as 40 years is a long time ago. And out of all the other possibilities in this video, this one looks the likeliest. However, this next example will definitely change your mind, as this next possibility is literally the highway that is featured in the music video. Well, well, well. Here we are at this iconic highway scene only 8 seconds into the Faithfully music video. I-195 is a very brief highway, being a spur out of I-95 in Miami, Florida. When putting the music video and satellite view side by side, this is a clear match. However, there are still going to be some doubters, but keep in mind that the music video was recorded 40 years ago, and 40 years is a long time, so things have definitely changed. Another thing that keeps bringing doubters is the direction of travel that the band is going. Some might think, if they need to go to Charlotte, North Carolina, why would they travel eastbound toward North Miami Beach? That is an answer I can't answer, as I was not part of the road crew, unfortunately. Anyways, looking back at the street view, this looks exactly the same as the above view from the music video. And get this, I was only a couple miles south of this highway when I took a vacation in Miami nearly 2.5 years ago. And at the time, I didn't know that the bridge I saw to my north was where one of the most famous scenes of one of the most famous music videos was filmed. However, if you watch my second road trip video, you can faintly see the bridge across the waterway, but it's extremely hard to view, even if you zoom in as far as you can. So with that, you now know where one of the most famous scenes of one of the most famous music videos is filmed. If you want, you could travel to this highway and recreate the trucks traveling down the highway. And I know good and well, next time I'm traveling to Miami, I will definitely travel on this highway and make a road trip video out of it. Also, the date of this video, if you couldn't tell or knew, is the 40-year anniversary of Frontier's album being released. And 22 days from now is the 40th anniversary of the first Journey Frontiers Tour concert in Nagoya, Japan. And I cannot believe it's already been 40 years since that. That's unreal. 40-year recording sounding pretty, pretty good. If you want to listen to that, there's a video on my second channel with that concert. It's a pretty good one. It's honestly one of my favorite Journey concerts of all time. So if you want to give that a listen, go right ahead. The video will be in the link in the description below. And with that, goodbye.